In today's video, I'm going to share a few tips for making your yard cleanup a lot easier in the fall. Because here in New England, we know all about leaves, pine needles, pine cones, you name it, it falls out of the trees and ends up on your lawn. So let's look at a way to make it a little bit easier to take care of your lawn. The number one tool for doing any cleanup fast is to get a leaf blower. Now, some people don't own these, or if you do, you might not think it's as good as it is, but that's usually because people have purchased the wrong model for what they're doing. So let's look at three very different models so that you can better understand the differences and get the right one for you. We'll start with a small blower. Now, this one's made by Makita, uses dual batteries, it's totally cordless so there's no engine involved, and it's handy because if you have other Makita tools, those batteries will fit those things as well. And this Makita is really well made and it's got a pretty good amount of power, but unfortunately the real problem is the runtime. Even with two batteries, you can only run this thing for about 7 minutes, and that is not enough time to do any kind of serious yard cleanup, and you're gonna be really frustrated if you have to keep recharging or swapping out the batteries. Now, I still like this thing and it's great if you're doing a small space or you just want to clean off a patio, but for most big jobs you're going to want to think about something a little larger. If you've got a medium-sized yard, this will be a much better option. It still runs on a battery so you don't have to deal with an engine, but this is a leaf blower made by Toro and it runs in a 60 volt battery. This is a pretty cool system because you can actually use different sized batteries. It won't give you more power, but a larger battery here will give you more runtime. Now here I'm using their largest one, and I can run this thing for about a half an hour. And you've got a lot more power so you can push the leaves and pine needles a lot further. But it does have some negatives because a blower like this is going to be more expensive than a small one. And because it has so much power, it also makes more noise. And you'll definitely have to wear hearing protection whenever you're using it. But what if you've got a huge space to do a cleanup on, you want a lot of power, and you don't want to deal with a battery? Well, that's when you can go with a gas-powered blower. And I recommend that if you're gonna go with gas, get a backpack unit. Now sometimes these seem pretty big for people, but they're a lot more comfortable to wear, and in the end of the day, you're gonna get a lot more power. And if you want one of the most powerful blowers in the world, this is it. It's Steel's BR800C. Now this is an awesome unit, but as you can guess, it comes at a really high price. And if you can afford one of these and you've got a lot to clean up, you won't be disappointed. This thing is loaded with features and it does a great job. But for most people, this is too expensive, and I recommend getting a unit like an Echo that's a lot more affordable, or even shop online, places like Facebook Marketplace or Craigslist. Buy a used Steel or a used model that's in great condition. And as you can see, the gas backpack unit does a lot better job doing the cleanup. If you've got a larger yard, this is the type of thing you want to consider, because if you get a smaller one, you're not going to end up using it, or it's just going to cause frustration and really discourage you from doing the cleanup at all. But what about cleaning up the lawn? Because what you're looking at here is just a small example of what we're going to get during the fall. Now the leaves themselves aren't the real problem, it's these things like the sticks and the pine needles. Because they're going to embed themselves into the lawn, and they'll really contribute to things like thatch or just smothering the grass altogether. Go ahead and use a regular mower, but equipped with a bagger. Now if you're in an area that doesn't get pine needles and you just get leaves, you can go ahead and try to mulch those into your lawn, and you might have to make a couple of passes, but that will usually work okay. But when it comes to pine needles, you're not going to be able to mulch them very effectively, and I recommend just using a bag and going over it with your mower. Now, a lot of people like to just wait until everything falls down to do their cleanup, and that's usually a big mistake. In the fall, I like to keep my lawn cut a little bit shorter, and the main benefit is by having it short like that, any debris that gets on top is a little bit easier to get off with a mower, and by doing your regular mowing weekly, you'll be able to do a better job cleaning it up. Now here you can see I've got a lot of debris from the woods that's mainly branches, pine needles, and sticks. And I'm using the Toro Time Master, which is a 30-inch mower that I recently reviewed. And this did a really great job in this space, but the key is to keep your lawn cut a little bit shorter and you'll get much better results vacuuming up debris. After I was finished with my cleanup mowing, the entire lawn looked a lot better, but unfortunately there's still a lot of debris in the grass that you don't easily see. So as we get closer, you can see a lot of things like pine needles are still embedded in the lawn. I recommend that you try to dethatch your lawn in the fall. You want to pick a day where the grass is dry, and I recommend cutting the lawn a little bit shorter because it'll make your rake going into the grass a lot easier. Now here I'm using a regular rake and you'll see that very little is coming out. And that's because you need a dethatching rake. Now those old dethatching rakes are awful, they'll break your back and they just take forever. I recommend getting one of these. This thing is called the Groundskeeper 2 and it really is the best rake on the planet. that has these little tiny wires and they get right to the bottom of the lawn. Now if you've got a smaller lawn, all you might need is this rake, but if you've got a larger space, I can recommend a better option that makes the job just as easy. And that's to use one of these. This is an electric dethatcher that'll make your life so much easier. Now I reviewed this earlier this year and this tool is really a winner because it's affordable and it really works so well. And when you look at my lawn, it doesn't really look like there's anything in it that needs to come out. But as soon as I make a couple of passes with this electric dethatcher, you can see a lot of debris. Now that's a mixture of dead grass, pine needles, and when you dethatch, you'll also pull up things like embedded sticks as well as acorns. Cleaning up your yard can be a lot easier with a few tips and the right tools, and hopefully this video has given you some ideas that can make that job a little bit easier. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're not already for more videos coming up.